This is how we start off in life. Asking for permission, seeking permission, and hopefully, usually, receiving it. But what I've noticed is some folks never grow out of that. They continue to seek permission. They wonder, why didn't I get that promotion? They ask themselves, how come I didn't get considered for that job, the new job that my company created? They worry, why? Why didn't I get a raise last year? They wait. They are expecting somebody to give them an opportunity for success. And I say, choose yourself. Choose yourself. You can make it happen. Take Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan was told he was too short for basketball. Michael Jordan, ostensibly the most wonderful, fabulous basketball player of all time, was told he was too short for basketball. So what did he do? He went out and proved them wrong. He worked hard. He practiced. He developed the skills he needed to be a successful, albeit the most successful, basketball player of all time. Michael chose himself. He developed the skills he needed. He became the basketball player he wanted to become. Michael chose himself. We set our own limits. And this is your life's work, so you want to set them high. Henry Ford once said, whether you think you can or you can't, you're usually right. So my advice to you is, choose yourself. I'm fortunate enough to be able to work with young men and women interested in advancing their careers. As a mentor and a coach, I have been surprised in how many of these young men and women feel like it's up to their bosses whether or not they get promoted. They feel that they're at the mercy of their bosses to move up. And I'm here to tell you, that's not the case at all. Choose yourself. You can make it happen, and here's how. Take stretch assignments. When your boss is struggling, has got an issue, she can't quite figure out how to solve, or your team is working on something that's not quite gelling, and there's an opportunity to step up, take it. Take the opportunity. Take that stretch assignment. The more stretch assignments you have, the more successes you have on your resume, the bigger and better your resume is, the easier it is for you to move up. And if you have that resume with all that really cool stuff on it, and you still can't move yourself up in your organization, you've got a resume that you can take to another organization that will appreciate your accomplishments and will put you in a position that you're looking for. Get out of your comfort zone. Toastmasters can help you do that. Toastmasters, by coming to these meetings and working through your manuals, will help you hone your communication skills and will get you to get those butterflies that you feel when you're standing in front of an audience to fly in formation. Toastmasters will help you be able to stand up in a job interview, in a presentation, speak off the cuff, without that kind of nervous, weird feeling that so many people have, will give you the confidence to choose yourself. What are those voices that you hear in your head? Ignore those voices that you hear in your head. Do you know what those voices are? When you're taking those stretch assignments and you are coming out of your comfort zone, those voices are simply your fear. Your fear of failure talking. Silence them. Toastmasters can help you do that. Keep coming to meetings, keep working hard, and Toastmasters can help you choose yourself and move yourself up. Also, be persistent. My mother got herself promoted at 73. My mother was a stay-at-home mom. She raised my brothers and I And then my brother was in high school. She started student teaching in the military school system. As you know, the United States has military bases all over the world, and their personnel have children, and the children need a place to go to school. So the U.S. military bases and schools on them. So my mother started student teaching. She got a bachelor's degree, she got a master's degree, and a PhD in education. And she worked hard. And over time, she got to be a deputy superintendent. And she sort of stuck there. She mentored young men and women who got promoted above her. She had colleagues and counterparts who applied for jobs and didn't get them and gave up. A lot of people were tired. And then mother had to be tired. And mother had to be tired. When my father got sick, a cancer, my mother kept going. She took some time, and she was able to do it, so she was lucky. She took some time to be with him, but she kept working, too. And 6 years, 6 years after my father passed away, my mother got her promotion to superintendent at 73. So I'm here to tell you, choose yourself. Don't sit there and think, I can't get promoted, it's up to my boss. Don't sit there and think, really, I'm not as good as that person. That person who got that raise, person that got promoted. Don't do that to yourselves. Choose yourself. Take stretch assignments. Get out of your comfort zone. Be persistent. It will all pay off. If you see a problem, you know, I tell people that work with me, see a problem, pick it up. See a problem, pick it up, and solve it. Sit around with your colleagues. Everybody's got them in their organization. Something that's just not quite working right. You guys can solve it. Sit down, figure it out. Talk to your colleagues. What do you think about this idea? Brainstorm, get it all packaged together, and then present it to your boss. Let me tell you something. Bosses love it when you do their thinking for them. You come all prepared, nice, tiny solution to a problem they've been struggling with. So choose yourself. Choose yourself.